Valerie, why are you wearing a hat with a little Q on it? Why am I wearing a triangle hat with a little Q on it? What? Ah, because it's a charge hat. So what we're actually going to be doing is making a way for you to remember how to calculate the value of a capacitor based on the charge that it needs to take in and then supply to the load to ensure that you meet a certain output voltage ripple. So here we have our buck converter, and we are going to look at the output currents. Remember, by looking at this node, we have current coming in from the inductor, and we have current going out to the load. That's where the majority of the current, the average current flow, will be going through here. But a little bit of current will be going into the capacitor and then coming back out of the capacitor. And I've drawn the waveform over here. So here's our inductor current. It's going to be a triangle wave because of the inductor properties and the fact that we're switching between two different states. And you're going to get this waveform, and we have our average waveform here, IL. And that's going to be the average value through the inductor is the same as the average value through the output, so IL, same as the average value. To understand this equation, we're going to start from this basic charge equation for a capacitor. And we know that Q equals CV, but here we want to look at changes in voltage at the output. So we're going to look at the delta of both of these. And because the capacitor is a constant value, it doesn't get a delta, it's just a constant. So what we can do is, if we want to get a certain ripple, so this change in the VC, because it's the same as the output voltage, it's equivalent to the output ripple. So if we want to calculate for C, all we have to do is figure out the change in the charge that we expect and divide it by the change in the output voltage, the maximum acceptable output voltage change. So all we have to do is figure out this charge, how much we expect to be taken into the capacitor and then given back out, and then figure out what our requirement is. All right. To do this, now we need to calculate Q. Q is the charge. And if we look at this figure, because the average inductor value is the average output current, the capacitor just has to make up this difference. And the difference is shown here. So here's charge going into the capacitor. And then here we have charge coming out of the capacitor. We know that at steady state, these charges need to be equal. So all we have to do is calculate one of these, this triangle of charge, and then substitute that into here, and we can solve for the capacitance level that we need. So let's do that. So first we'll do the change in charge of the capacitor, and it's going to be this calculation. We notice that this is a triangle, and so we can do 1/2 base times height, basic geometry. And now we just need to find these values. So 1/2, the base. The base is this full value. And notice T is here. And if you look at this, you can see that half of T is exactly the base of this triangle. So really, we have T over 2. And note that this does not depend on D at all. So this doesn't depend on the duty ratio. Then we multiply by the height. We know that this total height, the difference here is the change in the inductor value, so your inductor ripple. You do need to know that value already or calculate it, but you can do that. Then we want half of that, so 1/2. Okay. So we have these simple equations. Let's simplify this. And we'll get T delta IL over 8. So here's the charge that will be going into the capacitor. Now that we have this value for the charge, we can simply take that and put it back into this equation, and we will get the capacitance value must be equal to T delta IL, the ripple of the inductor, divided by 8 times the change in the output. So using this equation, you can calculate the capacitance that's required based on the expected voltage ripple, or the requirement, and the inductor current ripple. The reason this is important is because the buck converter is different in this calculation for the capacitance value than the boost or the buck boost converter. So for the buck converter, remember that you are looking at the triangle, the charge hat of the inductor ripple waveform, and you can calculate the minimum capacitance based on this equation. One last note is that this is an idealized calculation for the capacitance value, and if you want to decrease the ripple, you would increase this capacitance value to maintain a steady voltage at the output.